दिल के शहर में जब भी गूंजे ये शोर, वी गॉट सो मच लेकिन वी वॉन्ट सम मोर। दिल से कहते रहो तुम दिल की ये बातें सारी, वील बी देयर फॉर यू ऑलवेज जस्ट लाइक बिफोर। अब तो शहर भी है अपना और दोस्त भी है अपने, जज्बा भी है जमा जमा। सो टर्न अस ऑन एंड फील द सॉन्ग, अब जाए हम जहाँ जहाँ। सिटी 1016, यही मेरी दुनिया। आई डोंट नो इफ आई गॉट दैट सॉन्ग कम्प्लीटली राइट और नॉट, आई ऑल्सो डोंट नो इफ माई वॉइस वॉज दैट ग्रेट, बट आई वट आई डू नो इज दैट इफ यू हैव बीन टू दुबई यू डेफिनेटली नो अबाउट यू एज लार्जेस्ट रेडियो स्टेशन सिटी 1016. दिस वीक ऑन करी कनेक्ट मीट द गर्ल हु मेक्स यू चिल टू नाइट एवरी नाइट, मरियम के साथ, आर जे मरियम पॉपुलरली नोन एज, शेयर हर स्टोरी अबाउट हर मैजिकल मीटिंग विद शाहरुख खान एंड ए आर रहमान, एज वेल एज हाउ हर जर्नी टू बिकमिंग एन आर जे हैज बीन लाइक। चेक आउट, आई नो यू आर गोना लाइक इट।
तू सुन ले तो आओ कभी, छू कर तुम्हें खिल जाएगी, घर इनको बुलाओ भी। बेकरार है बातें करने को, कहने दो इनको जरा, खामोशियां तेरी मेरी खामोशियां, खामोशियां लिपटी हुई खामोशियां।
Hi, मैं हूँ मरियम एंड वी आर विद दिस लवली होस्ट करिश्मा एंड वी आर वॉचिंग करी कनेक्ट। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल फॉलो करिश्मा ओवलाटे, शी इंटरव्यूज अ बंच ऑफ इंडिविजुअल्स अबाउट देयर लाइव्स एंड जर्नी एंड इट इज एब्सोल्युटली फैंटास्टिक।
वाओ, दैट्स सम कंटेंट दैट वी नीड टू गेट इंस्पिरेशन फ्रॉम।
थैंक यू।
बट वर यू ऑलवेज लाइक दैट? आई मीन, हाउ डिड यू बिल्ड ऑन टू ऑल दिस? हाउ डिड यू बिल्ड ऑन टू दिस confidence and then becoming an RJ and your journey till now?
So, you know, something very different with me, I get very nervous when I just have to talk to one person or have to talk to like a few bunch of people in a conference room. But if I'm on stage, I just love it. I love being on stage. Yeah, I love that so much. But I started off, you know, just performing in front of my family, my friends first. And then I went on with that. I got a little more confidence. I started off in school, then in college, and then just went on and on and on. I think that's what you do. You start with your closed ones first. That's the best thing to do.
But did you always know that this is the profession for me? Or like, did you dabble into different fields and then come?
I always wanted to get into entertainment. I didn't know what sort it would be because I started off dancing first. I've always loved dancing more than singing. Okay. And even now, actually.
That's a first, but everyone listens to you for singing.
Yeah, I don't think a lot of people know I love dancing more than singing. Huh. But that's my first love. And then I saw my dad giving more time to my sister because he likes singing and my sister used to sing. I used to get very jealous. I'm like, you know what, I have to get into this. And that's how I got into it. My dad taught me a little bit. And then it was just, you know, from the videos and the songs that I used to listen to.
So you're not trained? You've
No. No, my dad is not trained. Whatever he knew, he taught us, me and my sister Alifia. And that's how I went about it. I was actually a marketing student, a PR and marketing student. And I worked as in a marketing agency in an event company before I joined City 1016.
And how did you land up at City 1016? What was the experience like?
Okay, so this story, I don't know whether you know, but I was a diehard fan of City 1016.
We all have been brought up in Dubai. It's like a thing.
Yeah, I know. And I called them once, or I took part in a Flight City 1016 contest. I won that contest. Right. I went to Prague with the team.
Oh, wow.
And you know, yeah, going from one spot to another, bus mein jo time hota hai na, RJ's ke saath, that is the best, okay, for me, because we played in Antakshari and all of that. Yeah. And well, I sang, and they called me in for an unplugged session after the trip got over. Wow. Then from there, they gave me an opening for an Adnan Sami concert. And Malu comes up to me once and tells me, you know what? You should try RJing. It should be your thing. I'm like, oh, okay, maybe she's just saying that because she is too sweet, first of all.
Yeah.
I'm like, okay, she's just saying it. The next day, I get a call from our boss asking me to come for an audition.
Wow.
And then here I am.
So I think it's all about taking that opportunity. Because if you would have
exactly
taken that opportunity, I think the key there is the word opportunity.
Yeah. Absolutely. Grab opportunities.
Yeah. Sometimes the wrong places actually make you land up where you're meant to be, you know.
And exactly. Exactly.
Yeah. But yep. Tell me one thing. Is it all fancy being an RJ now that you are in the field? You know, bahar se to bada fancy lagta hai, yaar, shows ho rahe, events ho rahe, ho rahe. But like, yeah. How is it actually on the inside? What are the kind of challenges and opportunities that you face on a regular basis?
So I'll tell you. 80% very fancy, because I'll tell you why. The people who are involved, the people who are part of City 1016 are all passionate. And you ask each one of us, we all love our jobs. Hmm. Not a day I went to work thinking, you know, yaar, kaam pe jana. Not a day.
Every day.
And I felt like, wow, you know, I have to go to work. Yes. And I'm not just saying this. I'm really not just saying this, but... if you have that passion, you would love going to work. Yes, of course, there are challenges. Stuff like, you know, before becoming an RJ, I never used to think about what to say in front of people or what to post,
yeah.
You know, stuff like that. Now, things might just matter.
Yeah.
You got to take extra care about what you put out there. Even if it's funny, even if you're trying to just make things a little lighthearted, you have to think twice about what you put out there. So yeah. That's something, but I think that's good in a way. But otherwise, I think going for events, getting ready, you know, listening to music is my job. So,
yeah.
I mean, I love it. If I watch Coffee with Karan at work, my boss thinks I'm working. So I love my job.
The first time you went on air, okay, because I had heard it, and even the first couple of weeks. And
yeah.
I must say that there's a remarkable difference between you then and you now, which is something personally as well, yes. Because I could make out, and the best part about radio is you connect to the voice, right? That's the only way
yeah.
to put yourself yeah. out there. So I could see the shift in your voice since then. And that's exactly where I'm going to touch upon that. If you know, there are these, since you're into RJing and since you are into the public speaking profession, what are the kind of, maybe three tips about how you work onto your voice modulation or your public speaking skills through your profession?
So I'll be honest, I never worked towards my modulation and all of that. That just, I think I kept listening because I was always a listener. I understood the way they spoke and how it needs to be done. I used to listen to a lot of podcasts. I trained for 2-3 weeks before I went on air. So I understood, you know, there's a way of doing a link. Now, every time you go on radio, you say, I'm going on and doing a link. That bit is called a link. And there are ways you should always end with your take, what I feel about what I just spoke. That is how you end a link. Okay, so these things are something that I worked on. Always, even if it's criticism, constructive criticism, always make sure you work on those because that will help you the most. That's my first and foremost tip. Don't ever take it in a negative way because that's never going to help you. That's what I did. I even made sure that with my boss listening to all my you know, links before I went on air, I made sure that normal listeners, like my friends, heard it. What did they think of it? You know, my Hindi, even now, honestly, it's really bad, but I need to work on my Hindi because our listeners are Hindi, Hindi speaking. And I still write it down. I script whatever I want to say because my Hindi, my grammar, oh my God, it's horrible. So stuff like that. Always, so first tip, always take constructive criticism very, very seriously. Second tip, make sure that you have close ones listening to what you're doing or watching what you're doing because they are the ones who will actually tell you where you're going wrong. They won't care. They're not going to be all nice to you.
Yeah.
You know, And third, just keep practicing. Just keep practicing. Yeah. Listen to yourself. Watch what you're doing. You yourself will understand where you feel, you know, there's a little bit, you're lacking somewhere there. You understand yourself. So watch what you're doing as well. And when you said, you know, I've heard your first link now, that's because I go back and listen to what I used to do, compare it to what I'm doing now, and try to see the difference as well, you know?
Yeah. I think
so. These are the things,
But then tell me one thing. Has there been a moment that you're going to hold close to your heart? Any memorable interview or encounter that you have come across in the years that you've been working now? How long?
So
it's
been 2 years.
It's been 2 years. Okay.
2 years. I know. But you know what? I don't feel it. I feel like I just started like last month. It feels so new to me, you know, because every day is different. And that's what I love. So, I have two actually. One is when Shah Rukh Khan came to the studio.
Oh, wow.
And also because the entire team was together. You know, I don't get to see the breakfast team a lot because their timings, my timings are entirely different. When Shah Rukh Khan came into the studio, the entire team was there. We all spoke to Shah Rukh. We all had our questions. At the same time, so when he came to the studio the next day, we had to all go up on stage at Global Village. And he remembered our names. And for me, Shah Rukh Khan remembering my name when I enter, it's like, oh my God, you know? And you learn a lot from that. I'm thinking if Shah Rukh Khan can remember your name, who are you to act, you know, just be grounded. That's what he taught me. And second is A.R. Rahman, when he came into our office and when I could sing in front of him. It's just
magical.
I mean, it's something I can't even explain. Speechless when that happened.
Yeah, I can imagine. I mean, it's different when you're standing in front of them. I remember when I went to interview Vidya Balan once. And I came out of the interview and I didn't even expect her to, you know, exactly. I didn't expect her to remember my name or anything. But then during the interview, I think she used my name. And when I went back to the edit bay and I saw the video, I said, oh my God, like she actually registered this because nobody else does.
Yeah.
So it's just remarkable.
Teach you a lot.
And I also think it teaches you, tell me if you've experienced this, because earlier, like when I used to meet a star or jab hum pehle Bombay jaate the, it used to be like, oh my God, you know, star hai and you're all fans and this and that. But then eventually when you get into the public space and you go to interview them, you respect them, but at the same time, you can't act like a fan or something. You have to be like,
yes. So this happened to me initially. I was very, I met John. I've been a diehard fan of John for a very long time. Yeah. And he was one of the first celebrities that I met after joining City 1016. So when I saw him, I was like, oh my God. And my boss is like pinching me from behind, like, can you calm down? I'm like, yeah, okay, cool. I just sat down next to him. I didn't ask him even one question. My team did that for me. I was just sitting next to him and just looking at him. And that's it. I think it took me a while to get there because I've been a diehard fan of Bollywood. And, you know, I can't just become all, you know what, let me just ask you a question now. But yeah, it took me a while. I got back to my senses after like 10 minutes and then I asked him a few questions. It was fine.
The thing about radio that I found really amazing is that, you know, in fact, I've even done a video on this, that you're sitting in the car and you suddenly, I don't know, for me personally, I feel like there's no other medium that makes you listen to music that way, where, you know, you're thinking of a song and the next thing you know is, acha, that played. And you're like, oh my God, this is like a twist of destiny or something, because this just played right now. Personal medium. Do you feel with that way? Do you agree with it? What are your opinions on it?
I do, actually, because it's so relatable. I was, you know, I remember a listener coming to me and telling me what he remembered, something that I would have done maybe 3 months before I met him. Mm-hmm. And he said, you spoke about sibling love and how you all fight and all of that. He was with his sister in the car and they started talking amongst themselves about how the exact same thing happened to them. So it's very relatable. And even in terms of music, for instance, what we try to do is talk about the music, talk about the singers. We always picture the video of the song, you know. What I try to do is try talking about the singers, about their lives, about the song, how was this composed, and then I play that. So you automatically kind of relate to that song in some way or the other. And then, of course, songs, music, it's like a stress buster. Whatever you try to listen to according to your mood always helps. Yeah. And we try to kind of shuffle that on our station. So I think some way or the other, you're always related to radio in some way or the other, whether as a listener or a presenter or anyway. Yeah,
it is. It is. It is still one of the forms. I mean, even print has slowly died, but radio has remained on the...
Yeah, and it's a two-way communication, which is best, which is the best. You know exactly what's working, what's not, in terms of the messages coming in terms of the phone calls, you know, and radio has become so visual as well. You know, the videos that go up, the comments on that.
There's a lot more exposure. Yeah.
Exactly. 30 years back, if I was a radio presenter, nobody would know how I looked.
Really, yeah.
What made you start Curry Connect? How did you get into, you know, because it's such a fantastic thing that you're doing, you know. It's nice to share my story. I don't do that a lot. So thank you for this opportunity, first of all. But tell me how you got this idea and how you started it.
It's, first of all, thank you for all that you said.
You deserve it.
Thank you. It started actually, none of it was me. It was mostly, I've been a reporter with Quint before. So that's where my family and everybody around me saw me doing this thing. And they are used to like the little bit of nautanki that I do at home as well. So they said that, you know, and I'm in a phase where I was like, I was looking for work as well as I was working. But then I just got done with my master's as well. So I had newfound time on my hand. And then they said that, you know, why don't you finally like start something of your own? And they were looking at all these bloggers and everybody else. And I was, in fact, very doubtful. I didn't want to go ahead with it. I said, nahi dekhte hain kya hoga and everything. Until one fine day, I just said, something clicked in me and I said, okay, let's just try. And I was in Pune at that time. And I told my mom that, you know, there's a Mausi down and she owns a grocery and I want to remove such stories out of the universe around me. You know, I want to like talk to people who have like their own insights. So she went and spoke. I didn't even have the confidence to go down and talk to her because I was like, pata nahi manegi, nahi manegi. She went and spoke. So mom went and spoke and I said, okay. And she said, haan, karega na, kyun nahi karega, aajao, aap karenge hum log. So she was really sporting. And that's where it started. So I literally just dapped on a little bit of lipstick, wore a dress and just went down, took my camera, selfie stick, and I just went and, you know, interviewed her in like 5 minutes, came back up, and that's how Curry Connect's first video happened.
Wow. Yeah. That's inspiring. That is inspiring. Yeah.
Thank you.
Like I said, no, you got to grab opportunities. Don't worry. I'm glad that you started something of your own. I think you're going to go places.
Thank you. It means a lot. I hope so.
Thank you for today.
Thank you for being a part. Thank you so much.
Of course.